lovelies. Happy New Year, and I hope you had a Merry Christmas. I want to start off 2019 by sharing my cleaning system for my new home. For those of you who are new, I am Raveena, a certified professional organizer and counselor. Do subscribe to my channel to watch my weekly organization videos. Now, in 2018, I did share my planner, and I did mention that I will need to rezone my areas for my new home. So if you have watched that video, you would have seen my set of binders that I got from Typo. And if you haven't, you can click on the card above. This year, I'm using this kikki.k planner that I already have. It is in the color cherry red, and I love the little button as well as I love the gold detailing along the spine. And what I have here is this book from Typo that I bought last year. So what I have done is I have removed these pages from inside. These are the monthly tabs, and then I have stuck something behind it, and I have also punched holes so that it would fit inside my new planner, or rather inside my recycle planner, and then I have rounded off the corners using my corner cutter. So what I'm going to do here is just put these into my planner. Here are some of the things that have come with the planner, which I haven't used yet. So I'm just going to leave these in the back. Now in the front, I'm adding my monthly dividers. So I'm adding January over here, and then the rest of them on the left. And what I'm adding in next are these schedules that I have made. My daily routine, my zones, which I have divided my home into, and I'll just tell you about that in a bit. My daily cleaning, my weekly and monthly cleaning schedules as well. So, my daily routine reminds me of all the things that I have to do in the morning, such as my personal time, breakfast, feeding my puppy Zoe, I prep for lunch, I unload the dishwasher from the night before, and I also do my daily cleaning, which you will see corresponds with the next couple of pages as well. And then I work on my YouTube channel for a while, and after lunch, I switch my laundry, do another load of laundry if necessary, do some ironing if needed, and then I start prepping for dinner. And I also do my zone cleaning, and again, I will show you my zone cleaning in just a bit. And later in the day, after working on my social media for a while, I feed Zoe her dinner, I make dinner and have dinner with my family, and I can do any more cleaning that I need to do. Usually, at this time, it will be some monthly or seasonal cleaning. And then at the end of the day, we finish loading the dishwasher and clean up the kitchen and dining table. Then I make sure to schedule in some personal time before bedtime. So on this page, you can see that I have divided my home up into zones. The blue one over here is zone 1, which is the dry kitchen, wet kitchen, pantry, and utility bath. I haven't included my laundry room and linen closet in here because it becomes too big an area to clean in one day. And this keeps my zones more balanced. Then I have zone 2, which includes my entrance, living room and dining room, which is this part of my house here. And then zone 3 are these two bedrooms and bathrooms. I don't have very much to do here because my kids look after their own rooms when they are home. And zone 4 is the master bedroom and bathroom, which of course is totally my husband and my responsibility to keep tidy. And zone 5 is the home office and powder room. And because it's a pretty small area, I have added on the laundry and linen closet into this zone as well. And lastly, zone 6 has the guest suite, courtyard, balcony, and service ledge. These are mainly the more outdoorsy open spaces of my house. Or they are in the outer circle, like the guest room. So I've got the guest suite here, and then the courtyard, the balcony, and the service ledge, which individually don't require much cleaning on a weekly basis, and in fact, no cleaning on a daily basis. And this list basically has all the things that I need to be done in these areas every day. So in the kitchens, I throw the rubbish, I sweep and mop, I clear the counters, etc. But when it comes to zone 3, making the beds, tidying the rooms, and sanitizing the bathrooms are my kids' responsibilities. For zones 4 and 5, there is usually quite a bit to be done, But zone 6 again doesn't require anything on a daily basis. These are spaces which only need tidying weekly or monthly. Or if I have a guest staying over, for example, then I need to clean up, which is why I think this zone method works really well for me. Okay, so now taking a look at my weekly cleaning page, you can see that all the zones actually correspond to a day of the week, Monday to Saturday. On Monday, I clean the refrigerator 1, and then the next week, I clean refrigerator 2. I polish the countertops, refill the bottles of detergent, clean behind the appliances, and tidy the snack drawer. For me, this system works really well. It has made my life so much easier because now I know exactly what needs to be done every day of the week, and no part of my home is being neglected. And because it is purposefully customized to fit my family and our lives, it works perfectly for us. And it also leaves me with time to work on other aspects of my life without getting overwhelmed. So straightforward, this is what I do on Tuesdays, on Wednesdays, Thursdays, etc. And what's great is that because my Wednesday is zone 3, my kids clean their own rooms and I can schedule other things to do on this day. I usually run my errands on Wednesdays and get my groceries. I also have these extra sort of tasks, which is like mop all the parquet floors and then mop all the tile floors over here. And if you look back at my floor plan, this part of my house is almost entirely parquet and this half is tiled. So by separating these two areas, I can alternate the mopping and it just makes it that much easier and more manageable once again. Then we move on to my monthly schedule, which again is broken up into zones. But this is a list of things that need to be done every month. I do these tasks on the first week, these on the second week, the third and the fourth weeks as well. So all the tasks are evenly spread across the days of the month. So because it corresponds with my weekly cleaning, in addition to all the things that I do on Monday, I also do one set of these tasks on a specific week of each month. Now I'm adding in these inserts for January, which I've just made on my computer. As you can see, since this month started on a Tuesday, I have added this banner over the top here where Monday would have been. I customize these pages for every month, usually 1 or 2 months only ahead of time. And I have been doing this for a few years now, and I find it works best for me this way. And what I do try to have every week is this month at a glance calendar. With the current week highlighted for easy reference, and from Monday to Saturday, I have these boxes which I use to plan my weekly menus. As you can see, not much extra cleaning or errands have been scheduled for this week, being the first week of the year, since we are still just settling back into routine. But I do plan to remove all my Christmas decor on Friday and refresh my home decor before Epiphany Day on the 6th. I also really love to add these unique holiday and special day ideas, which I find online, because they're usually special little things that we might otherwise neglect or not consider. And I think it's a nice touch to have in my planner. It adds this pops of color, which I really like. I also really like adding these clip art images to go along with them, just for that added cuteness factor. Like over here, we have Pet Day, which is just a special day which reminds you to give your pet lots of extra TLC. And as you can see, I have friends scheduled to come over for dinner this Saturday, which was arranged a couple of weeks ago. And I also include things like appointments, such as sending my dog to the groomers, which will be next Friday. And here in the next week, you can see the third week has been highlighted on the calendar. And right on the bottom of my page, I also like to add some fun hashtags. So for this week, I have put Beyond Blessed. And the previous week, it says Homemaking and Homemaker, which are just inspiring, or it's just something I use to remind me of my weekly focus. Over here, I have a hot and spicy special day, which I would probably include when I'm making my menu for that day. The other important thing I want to share with you all is that these cleaning schedule bookmarks that I have created, I have made 4 of these, one for each week of the month, and these include everything I have to do on a weekly and monthly basis. So coming back to my first week of January, I will just put this in here for easy reference. If you have watched my previous planner video from last year, you will know that I used to put these tasks down here every week and then repeat them every month. I found that it became very repetitive to do it in that way. So to improve my system for the new year, I have decided to put all these tasks on a separate card and laminate them. So once January is over, I can just take them right out and put them into the February section. This has allowed me to downsize my planner as well, and I really love having a smaller, more compact household management system at my fingertips. And what's great is that Monday, Tuesday, and Wednesday correspond with this side of the weekly spread, and then you flip it over, and Thursday, Friday, Saturday correspond with this side, with Sunday being my catch-up day. Another great feature is that I can also use my mile liners to check off tasks as I go if I want. And because I've laminated these pages, I can easily wipe it off when I'm done. So now I'm adding in week 2's bookmarks for next week. And then as you can see here, I have the task broken up into different rooms within each zone as well. Again, just for added clarity and efficiency. And because I'm tidying my home office on this day, I also have an extra task in this box which says pay bills, which is perfect because I can do both those things together. So I have these extra tasks I have spread out as well, which are not cleaning related but definitely important for household management. And every Tuesday I like to do my menu planning for the week so that every Wednesday I can do my groceries and meal prepping. So now I'm just quickly going to show you the rest of the January pages. I also move week 1's bookmarks to week 5 of every month, as you can see here. And now I'm just going to show you a quick overview of February's pages as well, which I have already printed and will add to any appointments and things by hand. And on the back of the month, I'm adding this notepaper, which was also from my previous binder, and I don't want to waste them. So what I've done is I've rounded off the corners again and punched in the holes so that it fits perfectly at the back of the month. And the real reason I wanted to upcycle this planner really is because I have a stash of a lot of lovely accessories in similar colors. A lot of them from the same kikki.k series as well. They are partly used, but there's still a lot of supply of paper here. There are also some tags and stickers. I have this large notepad, which I can use to jot down details for a guest staying over maybe, or for a meal I'm planning, and then just file them in. Similarly, I can cut out sections from here and add to my planner as well. Lastly, I have these extra stickers as well, which are really very cute, and I can't wait to decorate a little with them as well. And I'll be just keeping all of these things together so that when I'm planning my week and referencing my cleaning for the day, I can enjoy the process while keeping things super efficient and functional at the same time. I really hope you have enjoyed this video, and it's something which would be very useful if you have some old planners that you would like to recycle as well, because all the inserts are customized and homemade. I look forward to sharing many of my other ideas with you, so please do remember to subscribe to my channel and hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on any of my upcoming videos. Do leave me a comment and tell me if there are any videos you would specifically like me to share. So until the next video, this is Raveena wishing you happy homemaking.